All right, my moonbeams. I would like you to subscribe my stack is a little taller today because some of these are actually Christmas presents. Before we get to the DVDs, I would like to talk about Little Joe the Moonlight Cat. He wields a wand. Now, how would you turn something... Sorry about that. That was an important phone call. However, it's over. How would you turn something like this into something a Jellicle could use? Would it be a bamboo skewer? A chopstick, perhaps? Or would it be something totally different? I'm going to tell you. Well, in Cats, you will know that Bestopher Jones uses a common teaspoon as a cane or a walking stick, and he plays golf with it towards the end of his number. A bamboo skewer is much longer than the teaspoon. Not at all wand-worthy, and when you measure it with the actual wand, it's not Jellicle size, you can tell. So no, the bamboo shish kebab skewer, not a wand for a Little Joe. The spoon measures about that length. This wand is 13 inches long. The chopstick, on the other hand, also measures longer than the spoon. Again, not at all a wand for Little Joe to use. It'd be more of a walking stick for a little kitten. So what is Little Joe's wand? It's this. Much smaller than the spoon. It is a caramel apple stick. The type of stick that you find in caramel apples, found during autumn, around Halloween. If you listen to the song Memory very closely, you will hear Grisabella singing, "Withered leaves gather at my feet." Hence, this is around autumn. Around the time these sticks would be found, people would be eating caramel apples and tossing the sticks aside. Probably littering with these, so Little Joe would probably find a rat gnawing on the apple core. Because if you watch Charlotte's Web, you hear Templeton singing a song about apple cores and melon rinds and all that type of thing. Such a thing that a rat would eat. So Little Joe would find the rat eating the apple core, and he would use this as his wand. So this is a Jellicle wand. Mr. Mistoffelees does not use one of these, by the way. He uses his hands. He's a hand. He's more attuned with his magic than Little Joe is. Little Joe uses a wand. So, a 13-inch wand that a human uses measures down to this angelical size. An elf story. This one was a Christmas gift. It goes under A for Anne. As does Arachnophobia, another Christmas gift. And Assassins with Sylvester Stallone and Antonio Banderas. The first Antonio Banderas movie I ever saw. Chit-chat. And Babe, good pig. And both Angels in the Outfield and Angels in the Infield. So a double feature. And Disney's Tall Tale with Patrick Swayze. Rest in peace, Patrick. By the way, someone gave me a thumbs down on my anime collection. Just because I don't have Akira and the Magical Shopping Arcade of Abenobashi. Don't give me a thumbs down. I'm working on it. Please, give me thumbs up. Like my videos. These are good videos. I don't know if I showed this last time, but Tangled. So I'm showing it now, so I don't remember if I showed it. So it might have slipped in one of the stragglers. I've struggled by. Another Christmas gift. The Rocketeer. I remember seeing this in theaters. I also remember the 3D comic book that came with it. I owned the 3D comic book. It was awesome. Came with a little audio tape. It's an awesome thing. Dr. Seuss's The Lorax. This is the only good version of The Lorax, by the way. Don't go after the DeVito version, because, no. That's the only good... Anything that they've remade of Dr. Seuss is bad. Get the original Dr. Seuss stuff, because all the other stuff is bad. This is one of my childhood favorites. And I love it. Dot and the Kangaroo. Dot thought, in the pouch of a red kangaroo. Hippity hoppity hoppity thump. That's the way they go. This is about a little girl that gets lost, and the kangaroo helps her find her way home. This is another double feature, The Cinderella Story and The Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants. Don't watch Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants unless you want to cry. There's... spoiler, there's death. Cancer. Here's another one I got for Christmas. A double feature of Tales from the Crypt, Demon Knight, and Bordello of Blood. Another Christmas gift. Fried Green Tomatoes and the Coal Miner's Daughter. Here's one I had for a while. Quest for Camelot and Cats Don't Dance. I'm almost done with double features. There's two left. Double feature of Zorro. The Mask of Zorro and Legend of Zorro. Last double feature, Major League Movies. Who doesn't like drums? Drumline. And if you like Caveman, Encino Man, Brendan Fraser's first movie. And when it was on, there was a TV show called Double Dare. It was on Nickelodeon. There are two versions of Double Dare. One was hosted by Mark Summers, the other one was hosted by Alex Trebek. The Mark Summers version was on Nickelodeon, and when the kids were asked, who played the caveman, they thought it was Pauly Shore, when it was actually Brendan Fraser. Because no one knew who Brendan Fraser was at the time. Encino Man was Brendan Fraser's big hit and big mark on Hollywood. Since then, he's made a lot of movies, right up until The Mummy, and Mummy 2. E.T., Phone Home. An anniversary edition. Fantastic Four! And Rise of the Silver Surfer. I don't like this version. Galactus as a big, huge storm cloud? That doesn't make sense. Galactus is a big, huge alien. Purple helmet and garb and such. He's not a storm cloud. Although he does go around eating planets, he is not a storm cloud. Ferris Bueller's Day Off. Firefly with Malcolm Reynolds, Nathan Fillion. And Serenity, the movie that goes with it. I know I said I was done with double features, but both of the Firestarter movies. Forty-8 hours, and another 48 hours. French Kiss. Fright Night, the not so good version. I like the original better, although this version does have Chris Sarandon in it. Love His Death Scene. This is not the good version. The only good scene in this movie is when Chris Sarandon dies because he gets eaten by the vampire. He's saying, Jerry Danvers, he's eating the original Jerry Danvers. It's awesome. That's the only reason for watching that movie, is to watch Chris Sarandon get eaten by, the only reason to watch this movie is to watch Chris Sarandon get eaten by Colin Farrell. Futurama Volume 1. We'll look at these guys. They look happier. And Futurama Volume 2. Guardians of the Galaxy. Tanalir Tavan is the bane of Gekko Neko. He wants his wand. His weapon. Get smart. All right. I forgot. Both Ghostbusters movies. G.I. Joe with a Snake Eyes action figure. I've always wanted the Snake Eyes action figure when I was a kid. Now I got one. Gladiator. Grease 2 with Michelle Pfeiffer. Grease 2. Apparently, I don't have the first Grease movie. Green Lantern. And I mentioned the Gremlins' favorite movie, Snow White, earlier. There they are. And the new batch. Gulliver's Travels by the Fleischer Brothers. I wish I owned the one that has Richard Harris in it. That was a cool one. Irving Berlin's White Christmas. Yeah. Rest in peace, everyone. Especially Rosemary Clooney. I was in Ohio when she died. Because I was burying my cousin. My favorite cousin, I might add. Yes, Mandy and Mylan, I do not like you. Brian was my favorite. Rest in peace, Brian. Sorry about that. I just yell out to my cousins. Just in case my cousins are watching, I do not like them, except for Brian and his sister. And the cousins on the master's side of the family, on my mother's side of the family, those are the ones I like. Brian was my favorite. This movie, and Jim, and Muppets from Space. Rest in peace, Jim Henson. He died too young, pneumonia. This is not a double feature, this is a triple feature. Austin Powers movies. Revenge of the Pink Panther. Rodgers and Hammerstein's Sound of Music. With Mary Poppins. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Volume 6, the original. The Golden Child. Anything with the word the in it belongs in the T's. Such as I showed this earlier with the Secret World of Arrietty, but the littles. And the perks of being a wallflower. It's Hermione Granger. And Percy Jackson. In the same movie. And I have one last anime straggler. Girls Bravo. This disc was my first Girls Bravo disc before I got the box set. Right. Before continuing on, Little Joe 2. The second version of Little Joe. This version is a copy of Mr. Mephistopheles. Because I was watching Cats, so I just copied the eyebrows and put white. It's pretty much a white face with a black nose and black lips. And the eyebrows are pretty much Mr. Mephistopheles from Cats. And that's pretty much it with this black thing as a thing as a way to cover the ears. With a black turtleneck and white around the neck and a green collar. And I had black tail. Now getting back to the DVDs. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, what they should have released in America. And what they did release in America, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 1. Got two versions of that. Take a choice on which cover you like better. Running Through the Woods or the Battle of London. I think Running Through the Woods is better. That's what they were doing. They weren't really battling in London. But whatever. And Harry Potter and Deathly Hallows Part 2. That's it for the Harry Potters. I saw all of them in theaters. I was about a few minutes late for, let's see, which one was it? River Phoenix or that one. Doesn't have blueprint. It was the Order of Phoenix. Was a few minutes late for the Order of Phoenix because when we got there, Harry was in the park and he was being taunted, and Dudley was already taunting him. So I wasn't too late for that one. Not like I was for all I'd missed with Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince was, or all I missed with Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix was the opening credits. Unlike with Angela Weber's Phantom of the Opera, where I missed 15 minutes. And all the story development, where she's singing Think of Me and transforming. Yeah, when's the last showing of, when you're that late to Phantom of the Opera, it's the last showing, and you know nothing of the movie. I mean, you might not even be there. It's like, I was totally lost in what was going on with the Phantom of the Opera. At least with the Harry Potter, I knew that Dudley was taunting him. I knew that they were in a park. I knew that they were running from Dementors. I had read the book, so I knew what was going on. The Phantom of the Opera, I mean, 15 minutes and with story development. I mean, I had missed all the story development with Phantom of the Opera, so it's like, I mean, she was already singing Think of Me and transforming. I mean, the stage was already transforming, and it's like, I mean, one second she's like half naked, and next second she's in this dress. It's like, okay, what's going on? That was weird. Heart Like a Wheel. Based on a true story of Shirley MacLaine, a drag racer. Another not so good version of How the Grinch Stole Christmas. This is just the storybook on DVD, narrated by Walter Matthau. May he rest in peace. Hudson Hawk, a movie about a man trying to get a cup of coffee. Incredible Hulk, first season. Incredible Hulk, second season. Incredible Hulk, third season. Incredible Hulk, fourth season. And Ang Lee's version of the Incredible Hulk. A 2-disc special set. Iron Man with Robert Downey Jr. 10 cent dice is the wrong way. In the cartoon, it's the Mandarin that kills him. By the way, what they did to the Mandarin in those movies was wrong. They turned him into Syndrome on drugs with a gun hiding behind an actor. That is wrong. That was Syndrome on drugs with a gun hiding behind an actor. That was not the Mandarin. I want the real Mandarin. 10 Makalag rings of devastation. Whoosh. Yeah, baby, that's the Mandarin. I mean, that was not the Mandarin. That was not the Mandarin. What I saw in the theater on my birthday was not the Mandarin. They owe me a Mandarin. Because that guy was not the Mandarin. Iron Man 2. The one with the whiplash. And Iron Man 3 with Syndrome on drugs, hiding a Syndrome on drugs with a gun, hiding behind an actor. That is not the Mandarin. That is an actor. I want the Mandarin! You know why they're called. Do you know why he's called the Mandarin? Because he's Chinese. I want the Mandarin! Ten Makalag rings! Like they showed in the cartoon. I mean, if you can make Iron Man fly, you can give me those rings. He turned them into costume jewelry. I gave you the... What's that movie? The Hunger Games Flip Off. There you go. I want those rings! I want the real Mandarin. That was not the Mandarin. Ruined my birthday. I think another thing that ruined my birthday was CC Bone. I go to a French restaurant. My mom makes a reservation for me to go to a French restaurant on my birthday, and they put me in the corner, and they don't even sing happy birthday to me. They give me cold food. It was a bad birthday at CC Bone. CC Bone, you owe me a birthday! And my mom's not gonna pay for it. Iron Man. By the way, this is real anger. The Muppet Show. This one has Elton John, Julie Andrews, and Gene Kelly. Mary Poppins is in this one. Yeah. Everyone in this one is dead. Bob Hope, Dom DeLuise, and George Burns. May they all rest in peace. Peter Sellers, may he rest in peace. John Cleese and Dudley Moore, may he rest in peace. The only one left is John Cleese. Steve Martin, Carol Burnett, and Gilda Radner. Gilda Radner, rest in peace. The Dark Crystal. Great film. And Labyrinth. Rest in peace, David Bowie. David Jones. Whatever name you wanted to go by. When he wasn't flamboyant, he was David Jones. When he was flamboyant, he was David Bowie. By the way, those are his clothes that he's wearing in this film. Just like these are my clothes that I'm wearing. That's my hat. Bought from the Suncoast Video that no longer exists. Alright. We have... First, second, and third seasons of Fraggle Rock. I don't think I have to say the title of these, they're self-explanatory. And what happens in them is kind of self-explanatory by the titles. Legend, with Tim Curry as the devil, which is why I think he'd be a great Grinch. This guy here would be a great Grinch. Legends of Ga'Hoole. Legends of the Guardians of the Ga'Hoole. That was a Ga'Hoole. Two owls get kidnapped by a bunch of owls. A couple of them escape. They find the Go'Hul tree, and the little owl here gets kidnapped as well because she gets betrayed by her older brother, and she gets moon blinked, and so the they get her back to the Go'Hul tree, and her one of her older brothers is like, "You gotta help her," and they're like, "We'll do the best we can." And by the best we can, we mean we're Gupper and us. What do you think we are, people? Yeah. It's about a bunch of vowels. A bunch of vowels with some sort of technology of sorts, but, yeah. Legends of the Fall. A depressing movie, to say the least. The River Runs Through It is a better Brad Pitt movie to see. Batman, Lego. Let's see. There's a Batman movie. Lego Batman. Lego Batman. The movie. Matilda. Look, it's Mrs. Doubtfire's little girl playing with playing mind tricks. The Avengers. Think I should put all my Marvel stuff together. Robin Hood, Prince, Men in Tights. Wish I had Prince of Thieves, but this is Men in Tights. It's the cat from Cat Returns, and Whisper of the Heart. Another title I'm not going to mention. Let's see. Men in Black. Let's see, are there two on there? Nah, it's just the first one. Yeah, Men in Black 3. It's the one where he travels back in time. Tell us where I'm. Apparently, it's another double feature, Tales from the Crypt and Vault of Horror. It's a midnight double feature. So it goes under M. Monty Python, Search for the Holy Grail. And The Life of Brian. NostalgiaCritic makes fun of this movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger being crucified next to Eric Idle. Mortal Kombat Collection. Both movies. This title explains my life. I've never been kissed. Nine. One of Elijah Wood's not so great movies. North. Movie about a kid who goes to sleep and has a weird dream. They call it a choice collection, but really? This is one of my sister's cast-offs. Office Space. The first PG-13 movie I ever saw. Once Bitten. By Jim Carrey. And Pan's Labyrinth. By the way, I saw it Once Bitten on TV, not in theaters. Planet of the Apes Collection. And Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. Another title that explains my life, but I do not own, is 40-Year-Old Virgin. Alright. I just had to stabilize the shelf, and, because my DVDs fell on the floor, but, these are the ones that just fell on the floor. Luckily, they were close to the floor. Peanuts. A Boy Named Charlie Brown. This is the movie. I also have a book. Speaking of A Boy Named Charlie Brown, I have the book, A Boy Named Charlie Brown. And I also have a little jaw harp. With little jaw harp. That stupid blaze. So you can get these at any musical store, probably. I got this one at Ted Brown Music Store. It even comes with instructions on how to play it. Before I go on, as I said, I own the Pokemon cards. Does anyone know this boy? He is Japan's version of Bart Simpson without the juvenile delinquency. That is what Ash Ketchum is. Ash Ketchum is Japan's Bart Simpson without juvenile delinquency. That is why he is always 10 years old. And Misty is 12. So in this Pikachu I've had forever. And as you can see, he's still on his box. There's a little bit of tape on the bottom of him. And a Mew. And don't let him sing. And when they had it at Burger King, got a gold-plated Pikachu. Anyway, back to the DVDs. Charlie Brown Halloween. Charlie Brown Thanksgiving. Charlie Brown Christmas. A tree just needs a little love, and they sold it at QFC. Practical Magic. Kill the cockroaches. All of them. Pretty in Pink. Prince Brat and Whippin' Boy. Which is which? The prince can't spell, but the Whippin' Boy can. Real genius. It's a shame about Val Kilmer and Joe and Wally. Val didn't see what was coming. Rent. Jonathan Larson's one and only hit. Rest in peace, Jonathan Larson, and thanks. Mark of Ages. I think this is one of my sister's cast-offs because I've never seen it. Rent was one of hers, too. Say Anything. Another one of my sister's cast-offs. Scent of a Woman. Never seen it. I've got two. Shark Tale. Is it me, or can you tell that she's a gold-digging fish? I mean, she's totally after... She totally wants him for his money. Shrek. And Shrek 2. Should have Shrek 3D at summer. Alright, one of my DVDs had gotten misplaced, but I found it. Got Shrek. Shrek 3D. I just got the little thing on there. And Shrek 2. (Clears throat) Space Jam. And when Space Jam came to VHS, I have the Space Jam coin with Michael Jordan and the Monstars on it. Spider-Man, the deluxe edition with Tobey Maguire. Spy Kids 3D, the only Spy Kids movie I own. Sleepy Hollow with Johnny Depp. Johnny Depp and Christina Ricci. Sixteen Candles with Molly Ringwald. Interesting enough, one of the protagonists has a last name as He's singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. Rest in peace, Gene Kelly. Star Wars, the fourth movie. A New Hope. This version, they used a box cutter to open the packaging because there's a slit. Not happy about that. This one, these are the originals, by the way. And Return of the Jedi. Is there any guy who doesn't like her in that bikini? Rest in peace, Carrie Fisher. Stargate SG-1. And the ultimate edition of the movie. Stardust. I'm surprised this movie didn't make better at the box office or on DVD sales or whatever. But I happen to like this movie. I mean, it's got swashbuckling, it's got sword and sorcery. I mean, what's not to love? You got a captive princess. You got a princess who's captive by a witch. You got a star that's fallen to Earth, who takes the form of a human, and this guy is trying to take her home to meet this girl that he thinks he wants to marry, but then he falls in love with her, and she falls in love with him. I mean, come on. What's not to love about this movie? I mean, not to mention it's got Robert De Niro in it. De Niro, man! De Niro's a great actor. And I happen to like his little Captain Shakespeare in the lightning thing. I mean, what's that to love about Captain Shakespeare? He plays it off like, I'm Shakespeare, roar! And then you see him playing Nancy Boy. It's like, you've never seen De Niro that way before. I mean, come on. What's not to love about Stardust? Stardust is great. Stella Luna. Movie about a bat that loses her family, and she gets adopted by a bunch of birds. Strawberry Shortcake. Yes, I own Strawberry Shortcake. Nostalgia reasons. Another Strawberry Shortcake. Another for nostalgia reasons. I do not watch the Strawberry Shortcakes all that often, but I do own them for the nostalgia. Alright. Got, Playdate Surprise with Strawberry Shortcake and, Sea Beach Party. Seaberry Beach Party. Again, I own the Strawberry Shortcakes for the nostalgia purposes alone. I really haven't. Actually, I think it's been like a few years since I've watched Strawberry Shortcake. Maybe a year or so. A couple of years. Box set of Christopher Reeve's Superman movies. All four of them. I even own one of George Reeves' movies in here. The one with the Mulman. Let's see, it's George Reeves and apparently I own a Fleischer movie as well. Yeah, let's see. Yeah, there's the first movie with Christopher Reeve. And then on disc 3 we have a documentary or Take Flight Development Superman. Making a filming behind the magic, restored scenes. You know, when they released this on cable television, they cut out the scene where she faints. When they released this on TV, they cut out the scene where she faints. Anyways, 1951, it's Superman and the Mole Men. That's the George Reeves movie I own. Yeah, Superman and the Mole Men starring George Reeves, and 1940s Fleischer Studios Superman cartoons. So this is a collector's item, people. Right here, what I hold in my hands is a collector's item. And I am not giving it up. Mine. Got it for Christmas. Not this Christmas, but I got it a few Christmases ago. Rest in peace, Christopher Reeve, and George, and all the other, Supermen who have passed away. At least Christopher Reeve passed on the torch to the guy who was in Smallville before he died. I actually like that episode. Plays a scientist in a wheelchair. Much like what Adam West does with Kevin Conroy when he plays the gray ghost, passing on the torch to Kevin Conroy in Batman the Animated Series. Anyways. Batman, Superman, Man of Steel. Yes, I am both a Marvel and DC fan. Sweeney Todd, the Demon Barber of Fleet Street, starring Johnny Depp as Sweeney. Everyone dies, except the kids. Another version of Sweeney Todd. One of these is a director's cut. Let's see which one's the director's cut. Sweeney Todd, director. One of these is a director's kit. This one. This is a 2-disc set. There we go. 2-disc set. This one's only a single disc. I hate these double tabs. Yeah. That's what it is. Single disc, double disc. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the first movie, 1990. Followed by Secret of the Ooze. This one has Ernie Reyes Jr. Shark Boy and Lava Girl, Dream, 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 Dream. I love Taylor Lautner's song in this movie. I'm gonna like this movie. Yeah, good job there, what's his name? Director Spikeheads. The guy who directed this also directed, Director of Spy Kids also directed From Dusk Till Dawn. So, yeah. Good job. Yeah. Good job, Robert Rodriguez. And we have this version of Spider-Man, and its sequel. I've never seen it. Don't need to see that. That's one of my animes that we... Don't need to see that. That was one of the animes. I'm not showing you my anime collection again. By the way, it was Animatrix. The Audrey Hepburn Collection. This one is Sabrina, Roman Holidays, and Breakfast at Tiffany's. The only one of these I've seen is Sabrina. Although I did get to see what Mickey Rooney looks like in Breakfast at Tiffany's. Because of YouTube. Thanks, guys. The Breakfast Club. Why is everyone laying on Claire? Care Bears movie. It also says Les Bisonos. Apparently, it says the Care Bears in French as well. I don't know if it's in English or in French. Haven't seen it. I've seen the Care Bears, but I've not seen that. Mickey Rooney is also in that movie. Rest in peace, Mickey. Good enough for the Goonies. By the way, Cyndi Lauper and I have a lot in common. We both have psoriasis. High and the mighty. The Hut. The animated version. Animated version. Ralph Bakshi's version of Lord of the Rings. I love this movie. Not because of nostalgia reasons, sort of nostalgia reasons. But I do love this movie because I think I may have told you the story of Red Lodge and the Blood. Yes, blood at the end of Lord of the Ring. When Theoden calls for Gandalf, and Gandalf comes a swinging in with his mighty sword, cutting down orcs. Yeah. There was a nurse who came into my room, and she's like, "Is that blood?" Of course it's blood. I love this movie. Great movie. Great movie for that memory alone. I love it. Especially the end. And then, we have Rankin Bass's version of Return of the King. So, yeah, Rankin Bass's version of The Hobbit, Ralph Bakshi's version of Lord of the Rings, and Rankin Bass's version of Return of the King. So, animated trilogy, all on DVD. This little cardboard thingy. I wish it were a box, but it's a cardboard dealy bopper instead. Whatever. Guys are too cheap for a box? Island of Dr. Moreau. Both Dr. Moreau and Val Kilmer have death scenes in this movie. So, yeah. I think it's Marlon Brando's only death scene. So, every actor needs a death scene, in my opinion. Every actor needs a death scene. Both Val Kilmer and Marlon Brando have one in that movie. David Thewlis has one in the Harry Potter movie, so. The Karate Kid collection. All four of them. Even has the next Karate Kid. You know, I saw The Sixth Sense and Woman in the Water and thought they were great films. So I thought that M. Night Shyamalan was a good director. Until I saw this. This movie sucks. Great anime. A great cartoon turned into the worst pile of there's no words for what he did to this movie. It's so bad. Do not watch it. Do not get it. Do not touch this movie. It is bad. Bad movie. Blockbuster, Buster, bust it. Because bad movie. This is the worst movie of all time. I mean, I thought M. Night Shyamalan was a good director until I saw this thing. I mean, my sister was like, did you not see that movie? I was like, no, but I saw Woman in the Water, and I saw The Sixth Sense, I saw Woman in the Water. She's like, oh, you saw the good movies. I was like, yeah. So I thought he was a good director until I saw this. I was like, oh, whoa. I mean, The Sixth Sense was a great movie, and The Woman in the Water was an excellent movie. I actually liked Woman in the Water, except for the Eat Lawn. I mean, we don't even get to see the Eat Lawn. I'm like, dude, you won't even let us see it. Really? That's like, man. I wanted to see the Eat Lawn. But no, we don't get to see the Eat Lawn. He puts us under the water, so we don't get to see the Eat Lawn. Great job, M. Night, with that one. But what you did with Avatar, no. What you did with Avatar: Last Airbender, I'm sorry, you suck at making Avatar: Last Airbender, which is why you didn't get to touch the other books. Bad movie. By the way, that's not even the boomerang. That thing is supposed to be a boomerang? That's not a boomerang. That looks more like a scythe. That looks like something we're cutting weeds. That looks like a weed whacker. Call that a boomerang? That's not a boomerang. Last Unicorn. Great movie. I love Rankin Bass. Lego movie. One of these days I gotta watch it. Lost Boys. Movie about vampires. Enough said. Man in the Iron Mask. Apparently the mystery's been solved. Mark of Zorro. What can I say? It's a Zorro movie. Basil Rathbone. And all four of the Matrix movies, including Animatrix. So, we got The Matrix, Matrix Reloaded, Animatrix, and Matrix Revolutions. Actually, you should watch The Matrix, you should watch The Matrix, the Animatrix, Matrix Reloaded, and then Matrix Revolution. You should watch Animatrix before watching the other two, because if you don't watch Animatrix before watching the other two, before watching these, if you don't watch this one, before watching these two, you will be lost. You won't understand anything like that's going on. And I guess I should have shown that one with my anime collection. And I didn't know I had it, so. Sorry. Well, one I should have shown with the Star Wars was Force Awakens. This is also on Blu-ray. This is Blu-ray, DVD, and digital. And then we got the Mummy Collection. I believe this one also has the Scorpion King in it. Let's see. Hard to tell. There it is. Yeah. It's got the Scorpion King. There it is. Got the Mummy. Mummy Returns. And the Scorpion King. The never ending story. I don't own two, and I will never own three. But, yeah. This is the. I saw this when I was 9 years old. So, not only does she break Bastion's fourth wall, but she breaks our fourth wall as well, because she tells Atreyu that she has brought the Earthling Child with him, so she breaks Bastion's fourth wall of the book, and then she's like, well, there are others who were with him, meaning us, who were with him when he was hiding from the bullies in the bookstore, and when he took the book with the Orin symbol on it, meaning that she was talking about us being with Bastion. So, yeah. So not only does she break his fourth wall, but she breaks our fourth wall as well. So, and they talk about and they complain about they complain about Deadpool breaking the fourth wall. I've never seen Deadpool, so I don't know how many fourth walls he's broken, but yeah, she's broken at least eight. The original Christmas collection. We got Santa Claus is Coming to Town, Little German Boy, and Mr. Magoo's Christmas Carol. And Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, Frosty the Snowman, Cricket on the Hearth. And a frosty PSA. Yeah, they call it Frosty Returns, but yeah, Frosty Returns is a frosty PSA on saving the environment. Give me Frosty's Winter Wonderland over Frosty Returns, please. Oof. Yeah, I'd rather have Frosty's Winter Wonderland over that Frosty PSA. Our limits for season. Box set. The Song of Bernadette. Bernadette Subaru. Saint Bernadette Subaru. A woman in Paris who saw the Virgin Mary something about the rosary. Anyways, she's told to eat the herbs and drink the water. She eats the herbs. I don't know if she. We don't see her drinking the water. But, yeah. Great movie, even though it's been black and white. And it stars Vincent Price. Rest in peace. Vincent Price. I actually saw Vincent Price's last film in theaters. Edward Scissorhands. Pebble and the Penguin. It's not the pebble, it's the penguin. I love Don Bluth films. The Princess Bride. Another Carryaways movie. This was before Carryaways was famous, and before he started doing cheesy stuff like Robin Hood Men in Tights. Another film I loved as a child, The Secret of NIMH. About a mouse trying to save her family from the plow. She has to move her house to the Lee of the Stone. Shawshank Redemption. Story about a prison. Enough said. Oh yeah, and false incriminate, criminate. False incriminate. My tongue doesn't work. Incriminate. Incriminate. Try saying it. The Simpsons movie. I wish I had seen this in theaters. I would have liked to have seen it in theaters. The sure thing. Never saw it. Although there is a DVD wandering around in there. Like it's lost. Yeah, it's got Daphne Zuniga. She was in that other movie that I didn't want to mention. Yeah. George C. Scott's version of the Titanic. This was on USA. I was actually living on a boat when they filmed this. When they released this one on the TV. So I got to see part of it, but not all of it. The Ultimate Cartoon Collection. Got all your favorites from the old days. Where are the roses? The Wedding Singer. Is Adam Sandler really a good actor, or is he just pretending? Wizard of Oz. It wasn't the flying monkeys or the witch that scared me. It was this guy. When they were saying lions and tigers and bears, oh my, that's the scene that scared me. It was because they were saying lions and tigers and bears, oh my, and out pops the lion going rawr, and then so I. 4-year-old little kid closes his eyes and misses out on a cowardly lion. Like, what'd I miss? I had to watch it again. And I was nothing more than a cowardly lion. First movie to have Daniel Radcliffe without being Harry Potter. Woman in Black. Get to see him shave. And Thor. And don't even pull that genie gag where I'm Thor, it hurts. I've heard it. Three to Tango. Thundercats season one. Thundercats season two. It's called Season 1, Volume 1, Season 1, Volume 2. Anyway, I say Season 1, Season 2. This one says Season 2, Volume 1. And season 2, volume 2. Gotta love Mummer. Tiny Toon Adventures, season 1, volume 1. And the Transformers movie, the Shia LaBeouf. And the Transformers movie, the Shia LaBeouf. Well, it seems I have five last stragglers of my anime collection, but they will wait until after this. I'm almost done with the main collection. So got the Fifth Element. I wish I had the original cover art. The Page Master. Again, wish I had the original cover art. Clash of the Titans. At least it's got the original cover art. Harryhausen Collection. Box set. Black and white version of the Titanic. Apparently there's a Dalton in both versions. Looks like there was Timothy Dalton in the other version. Diary of Anne Frank. V for Vendetta. Vampire Hunter D. Walk the Line. Watchmen. Willow. X-Men Origins Wolverine. X-Men First Class. Box set of X-Men movies. From First X-Men to The Last Stand. First three X-Men movies. The Wolverine. The 1992 X-Men movie, X-Men cartoon, from the first two seasons, Volume 1 and Volume 2. Young Guns. Zathura. And now for my VHSs. I have Prince Brett and Whipping Boy both on VHS and DVD. And I have The Meaning of Life on VHS. And I have Pokemon, the first movie, on VHS. And now for the five stragglers, let's go Voltron Force! Blue Lion with Princess Allura. The Yellow Lion with Hunk. The Green Lion with Pidge. The Red Lion with Lance. And the Black Lion, the Keith. And one thing I forgot. My Blu-rays of Rocky. I have never seen Rocky. Rocky 2 or Rocky Balboa. Those are the three Rocky movies I have never seen. The first, the second, and the last. What I know of Rocky 2 is that Adrian goes into a coma and tells him to win. That's what I know of Rocky 2. Rocky 3, I know that he works for the mob at the beginning, and Mickey tells him it's a waste of life. And then, Adrian is dressed all frumpy, and I guess she's working at a pet store, and is having fights with Polly. I don't know about what, but... anyways. And then, Rocky's punching on the meat at Polly's, and, Polly tells him he's breaking the ribs. And this is hearsay, but... I hear they go on a date. I don't know what the date's about. I hear it's at an ice skating rink. Or is that the zoo? I don't know. They go on a date. And then the fight. And I hear he loses the fight. He's all bloodied at the end, and he's hollering out Adrian, and she's hollering out Rocky. And she's not dressed frumpy, but she's dressed all nice now. And so he tells her that he loves her, and she says she loves him. So, the end. That's all I know about Rocky. Enough to put into the trailer. So you tell me, have I seen the Rocky movie? No, I have not. I'd like to see the Rocky movie, but this is Blu-ray. I don't have a Blu-ray player. This is the bane of my collection. Because I don't have a Blu-ray player. Anyways, on January 31st, Moonbeam 87 is going live for the first time. So tune in to Moonbeam 87 on January 31st, and please subscribe to my channel and hit the like button, hit the thumbs up, not the thumbs down, Please hit the thumbs up button. Like my channel. Subscribe. And hit notifications. Thank you. Thank you, my fellow moonbeams, for tuning in. This has been my anime collection and my DVD collection, and I have spent years on collecting all of these DVDs.